Yeah, once you get, see, this is the formula, right? So you started with the seed of 0. The first number you actually get is 7. And then from then on, you get 7, right? Which means this is a really, really bad random number generator. Really, really bad. Okay, now the one I gave you for the practice problem is also pretty darn bad, right? Because what you get is, here's your output in order, 9713, right? I just computed that. Once you have a 3, then the next random number you're going to generate is completely dependent on that 3. Nothing else matters. Well, that was how I started this thing with my seed. That's how I started it, with the seed of 0. That means the very next one I'm going to call, the next random number I'll get from here, from the 3, the very next one I'll get will be the 9. And then I'll get the 7 and the 1 and then the 3, 9713, 9713. Okay? It's going to cycle. All random number generators that use this technique will cycle. They will cycle. And that's why you saw on the JavaScript example, the demo I did, the numbers are so long, right? So that the cycle time is, I mean, these numbers, they're only, this is mod 10, they're only 10 possible digits, okay? So, but with a big number, four bytes, and a good formula, it'll be a long cycle time. Okay, so that is related to the next, that's very closely related to the next question on the practice exam, which was this one right here. And it's talking about, here, I'm trying to get you to tell me what's wrong with the random number generator. That's in number 6. That's what I'm trying to get you to do. Okay, so we just saw that this random number generator, so the answer to this is 3, 1, 7, and 9. If I look over a long period of time and I call the random number generator many, 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 many times, and I count up the number of times a 3 appears and compare it to the number of times a 9 appears, the 3 will appear as many times as the 9 will. In fact, 3, 7, 9, and 1, those are the only numbers that can appear, and they all appear exactly the same number of times. So 3 will appear 25% of the time, 9, 25% of the time, okay? And that's what I'm asking you for right here. That's what that question is trying to ask you for. So if I were to draw that out, let's make a new picture here, So I already know from exercising that random number generator from before that 3, 7, 9, and 1 all appear the same number of times. And those are the only ones that can appear because it's in a cycle, okay? That's the fact that it's in a cycle is not so important. What's important is that's the only things that can appear. So if I were to run my random number generator 100 times, and I was, in that 100 times, I'm going to generate 100 random numbers, right? And let's just pretend this is my sequence. 9713. I don't remember what the sequence was, but let's pretend that's what the second sequence is. 3, 9, 7, 1, 3, 9, 7, 1, 3, 9, 7, 1, 3. Okay, so I run this thing 100 times, and I go through and I count up how many times does the 3 appear. Well, it'll be one quarter of it. That'll be 25 times, right? One quarter of it. I have only 4 numbers. So one quarter of those 100 times will be the count for the 3. So this is the count, and this is the value. So for the 1, it'll also be 25 times. And for the 9, it'll also be 25 times. And for the 7, also 25 times. Okay, so now if I were to draw that picture where I have 1, 3, 7, and 9. Here I'm going to have 25% right here. And that's what I have for the 1, the 3, the 7, and the 9. Okay? And if I were to go through here, because between 0 and 9, I actually have many other numbers in between. I have, you know, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 3, 4, 5, and 6, 7, and 8. I've actually got a lot of other numbers in between. So if I were to ask you how many times does a 0 appear, you'd say that 0 appears 0% of the time. How many times does an 8 appear? Well, 8 never appears, so that's 0% of the time, right? So all these other numbers will never appear. That's what a histogram is about. It's just counting the frequencies. So this is the frequency right here. I've either got 0% or 25% for this particular example. Okay, so it's, if I turn it into a bar graph, it kind of looks like this. I don't draw very pretty pictures here, but I think you can see what I'm doing here, right? This is a really horrible random number generator. What you want for a good random number generator is, if I call something 100 times, I want all 10 digits to appear an equal number of times, 10%. I want every single thing to appear 1/10 of the time, right? So I would have this would be ideal, a good random number. Well, cycles are still bad, obviously, but you know, this is, at least your frequencies are improved.
So if we did 5 repeating numbers, then it would be 20%?
Yes, because 1 divided by 5 equals 0.2. So if you had 10 numbers, it would be 0.1. 1 divided by 10 equals 0.1.
Okay, so it's always going to be, it's either going to be 0 or they're all going to be the same percentage. It just depends on how many.
It depends on your particular formula. That's what I'm saying. It depends on your particular formula. So the one that we did just before you guys came in, let's see if I can. It's this one right here.
Would the only change if you added another random in between?
No, you can't do that. See, that's not how you're allowed to use it.
Oh.
A random number, this is the way you use it. You cannot use it any other way. For this particular random number generator, I seed it with a 1, but from then on, I only get. I'm drawing on my computer instead of my pen. I seed it with a 1, but from then on, I only get a 7. Okay? This is a really horrible random number generator. So if I were to do this thing 10 million times, okay, I'm going to get 9,999,999 out of 10 million. Right? That'll be my frequency. That'll be this nice big number right here, which is practically as good as saying 100%. Okay? Everything else is at 0. That's a really lousy, no matter what you say, that's just a lousy random number generator. Okay? What you want for a good random number generator, what you want for a good random number generator . Let's just say I go from 0 to 9. 7, 8, 9. Okay, what I want for a good random number generator, I seed it somewhere. I don't care where, but I'm only going to generate numbers in this thing. Okay, and I'm just going to be counting with hash marks, you know, like when you would play a game and you'd want to count how many times does one appear. So I'm going to generate, I drew a bad picture here for this, but I'm going to generate, let's say, the first time is a 4, and then the next time is a 1, and then the next time is a 4, and then the next time is an 8, and then generate a 7, and then a 1, and then a 3, and then a 4, and let's say a 4, and a 7, and an 8, and a 9, and a 9, and a 4, and a 2, and a 0, and a 0, and a 2, and a 3, and a 6, and a 6, and a 9, and an 8, and a 7, and a 7, and a 2, and a 2, and a 2. See, and it's kind of over time, if you call it enough, what you want is a random number generator that you cannot predict what will happen next. Any number can be equally likely at any time.
So
that's what you need.
That's like right there, it looks random, but eventually it's going to repeat. You just want to
Eventually it will repeat, but if you make a good enough one and you stretch it out long enough, it will take so long to repeat that it's called cryptographically secure.
Okay.
It's not guaranteed secure.
Right.
But it's the lifetime of the universe secure. Okay? Okay. Are we feeling okay then about random number generators then? I feel a little better anyway, maybe? Where's my stuff?